not very happy where she was, felt very confined, she was in a small company, wasn't happy. She was in a dog park, and one of the other dog walkers there that she would always see and chat to, turned out that she worked in this big architecture firm. And so they got talking, and they liked each other, so she offered to do, my friend offered to do some volunteer work for her, and it changed her entire career, because then they knew her as this can-do person, who, even though she wasn't very high up in her career at that point, and just shown herself to be so willing, and just gone out and talked to people, and brought up the information that she wanted to hear about, know about. And I think, you know, that's what you're saying, that network, you're always reaching out to people.
Always.
And then the people that you go, I want to know more about them, they're interesting, you just make those contacts. No one gets annoyed when you make a contact, when you run out to them and say, hey, you met, I can offer you this.
Very good.
Right hand, left knee.
good. Now, let's come down. You know what I do after we do this? I like this. Let's do a snake. Wait a minute. You need to see my 80-year-old seniors doing the snake. It is amazing. One more thing, and then we'll go back to coaching. You've got to do the opposite side. I can't leave you hanging. Left hand, right knee. Pull the knees to the left. Right hand up. Lean left. Lean. Now that hip on the right, push it back. Patrick, chest up, ladies. Pubic bone down. Breathe in. Breathe out. And it's snake time. Okay. What was the question? Your first session with me is always complicated. I need to know if we'll work together well. So I don't believe in asking people to pay, and then I'm like, no, I know I can't do this for you. And they're feeling like, no, she's not going to do this. So just know, if you ever just say, yes, my gift to you. And that's your time. I'll be here. If you're on the worksheet, would you mind moving to me? Oh, my gosh. Would you rather a car?
Okay.
I have some.
Well,
mine's here. Who wants some coaching? Take one. They cost a lot. Pass the leftovers. Say, you know what, lady, I'll check in with you. know, what's going on, and da 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 da. You know, does that answer your question? So it's not set. You know, I just don't etch anything in stone because we're all being really different.
And would you mind sharing some of your favorite, some of your favorite success stories?
Without revealing the names of people, yeah, I will. Wow. I got quite a pool of physicians that I coach. The world has changed for physicians. Whether it, I don't know, I'm not going to get into politics, what made it change, but physicians are trying to figure out their next step in life. And remember, these are people that have been experts in their field, and they know everything about their, I mean, these are really high-end, top-notch docs that I'm talking about. And for the first time,
so much
bye! No, no, leave, guys, and you have to, it was so nice to meet you. Thank you for your question.
Yeah.
They are now figuring out, you know, what do I want to do? They're almost being forced to figure it out because the prestige and the pay of being a physician isn't quite what it is. And watching them figure out their next step in life and being a part of that journey and watching them do the homework and take their life seriously, it's really been exciting. I've had people that were administrative assistants that needed to interview for a big position. And they came to me totally lacking confidence in their ability to set in an interview and articulate their story. You know, interviewing is all about telling stories and being very strategic about the story we tell. There is definitely not. So I worked with people who got that job. And I love it. They love, yeah, give them a hand. My clients know who they are. So, my favorites. I've had people that I've had to say, you know what, we can work together, but I'm going to suggest that you might want to take some medication for your anxiety because it just, you know, overly anxious. And they say, you know, yeah, maybe, and I used to do that, or maybe you want to think again about it. And they've been willing to try, that we've been able to successfully coach. So, I mean, you don't want to hold on for the sake of business someone that needs additional support in a different way than I'm qualified to give. And that's why you have a psychiatrist and therapist. So, is time up?
Yes, I hate to cut it short, but I'm going to...